Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. As we are on continuing in the Easter season, and especially during these days of Pentecost, preparation for Pentecost, I welcome you one and all in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today we understand the very important role of the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit identifies us as God's own. I repeat, the Holy Spirit is the one who identifies us as God's own. So to begin with, let me read for you from Ephesians 1:13-14. In Him, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and you had believed in Him, you were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance towards redemption as God's own people, to the praise of His glory. Brothers and sisters, here Paul is speaking to us on behalf of the Gentiles, that he tells us that Jews were always chosen, and they were the one who believed first in the word of God, in the promise of the Savior. But it was to the Gentiles who actually responded to the word of God. So it is about the Gentiles. Is saying that when you heard the word, what word? The word that was of God, the word that is the truth about God, the word that God loves you, the word which explained to them their reality of the wretchedness of human life without a Savior, the word which was the good news of salvation. So this was the word that they heard, and it was not only that they heard, but it was also that they believed in this word which came from the Christian preachers. And when they believed the word of God, the good news of God, the message of salvation, the message of forgiveness, the message of acceptance of the mercy of God, and that is when they were sealed with the Holy Spirit. They were anointed with the Holy Spirit. They were filled with the Holy Spirit. And it is so beautifully explained that they were sealed. Brothers and sisters, in those days, the word sealed or stamped was of great importance. Actually, Paul was meaning the word called Araban in Greek. Arabon or Araban in Greek. Even in those days, whenever Araban was referred to an amount that was paid as an initial token for the purchase of any material good or any commodity. But when an Araban was paid, it was an assurance or a guarantee that the remaining material will be surely paid for. It was like an assurance. Okay. Also, I can give you another example. Since I belong to a construction background, even if I have to issue a tender for the construction of, say, a building or an airport, so I ask the contractors, those who are interested in the construction, to pay an earnest money. So, which simply means that they are. The contractor is ready to participate in the tendering process. They are ready to accept if the work is awarded to them. They are also ready to complete the work that is awarded to them. So earnest money is an assurance that the contractor will be faithful right till the end, which is something which we call as a contract. But we know that God's dealing with us is much more than a contract. I think we all know it is not contract, it is covenant, right? So God makes a covenant with us, which is so much greater than a contract. Contract is usually two ways, two-sided, we say, right? Both of them, both the parties have to do their roles, and that is only when the contract is truly honorable. But it is not so with the covenant. Covenant is one-sided. God says, I have made a covenant with you. So even though I am unfaithful, even though I will break my promise, even though I will falter from my commitment, God will not falter. God will not revoke the covenant. God will continue to be faithful. That is the depth of the meaning of the sealing stamped with the seal of the Holy Spirit. That is what it means when they believed the word. When I believe, when trust and in the good news of Jesus, when I accept I am a sinner and Jesus has died for me on the cross to save me, I am baptized, I am refreshed, and I receive the Holy Spirit, which is the promise of eternal life, which is the promise that I become a child of God. I become an heir of God. As Galatians tells us, I cry out to God as my Father. He is no longer someone who is far from me, but now He has become my Father, because through the Savior, through His own Son, Jesus, through the salvation, through the redemption, I have become His son, His daughter, His heir. That is only possible because of what Jesus has done on the cross for you and for me. And it is completed by the stamping or by the sealing through the Holy Spirit, which is a sign that God's work is accomplished when I receive the Holy Spirit. So brothers and sisters, in a Christian life, it is important to know God better and deeper every day. I cannot remain at a level like Paul tells us, I cannot be having only spiritual milk all the time. I need to have solid food. So I need to grow in my relationship with God every day as a Christian, which means I realize the importance of the power of God every day in my life. I acknowledge His presence every day. I speak to Him. I entrust to Him my life. Whatever is the situation around me, I entrust my life to Him. I speak to Him. I place all my cares to Him, because God loves me. So that is the deeper way relationship which I need to grow as a Christian. And brothers and sisters, who helps us in this? It is none other than the Holy Spirit, because it helps us to identify with God as someone who is my dear Father, helps me to identify with Jesus, who is my only Savior, who can save me from my wretchedness, from my sinfulness. It is the Holy Spirit whom Jesus has given us before He ascended to heaven, as a counselor, as a companion, who is always with me, who leads me to truth, who reminds me about the word of Jesus, who always leads me to God, to enable me not only to know Him, but also to enables me to do His will. It is not enough to know God, not enough to receive the power from God or salvation from God, but it is also important to do the will of God which Jesus has taught us. So that is where the Holy Spirit empowers us to, and He identifies as God's own sons and daughters. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to pause for a while as we identify, as we allow the Spirit to help us identify ourselves to God as our Father. As I continue on this topic, the Holy Spirit identifies us as God's own. I would like to take you through a few blessings of how the Holy Spirit identifies us as God's own. First of all, when I receive the Holy Spirit, or when I possess, or when I inherit the Holy Spirit simply through the salvation message, which is a free gift from God, I am aware, I immediately become aware that I am not somebody who is alone, or but I belong to God. I immediately come to that understanding that I belong to God. It happened with me when I was baptized in the Spirit. I immediately, my relationship with God as my Father was revealed in such a deeper way. I never considered God as my Father. No, my whole mind, my heart, my whole being cried out to God as my Father. Suddenly I had an awe feeling that I belong to God. God is my Father. That sense is given to us, each one of us, by none other than the Holy Spirit. Secondly, the Holy Spirit shows us God's will to be His witnesses. The Holy Spirit shows us to do God's will. Once He shows us, He also enables us to do God's will. Because again, like I am attached to God, my Father. Like if I love someone, like my dad, I will always look for ways to please my dad, to do what he tells me. So similarly, the Holy Spirit will help me to know God's will and also enable me to say yes to His will. Whatever way, whatever is the price also I may have to pay, but He will empower me, encourage me, and give me all the grace to do the will of God. The experience of the Holy Spirit which we have in this world is like a foretaste, a beforehand experience of the heavenly life. It may be so less, you know, compared to the greatness and glory of heaven when you and I will see the Lord face to face. So you can imagine that it is so great, that experience. But what we experience here on earth is only so much little foretaste, we call it. Even though we feel it is so powerful, that can change my life, that can turn the world upside down for me when I receive Jesus as my Lord and I am blessed with the Holy Spirit. It may seem so great, but brothers and sisters, let me tell you, it is only a foretaste. Can you imagine the heaven and its glory with Jesus, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, which I will have that experience when I go into His presence? It is far more greater. But the Holy Spirit surely gives us a foretaste of the blessedness of heaven. And it is again assurance. The Holy Spirit gives us an assurance or a guarantee that one day you and I will enter into the complete blessedness of God. So beautiful. We will enter into a complete blessedness of God. The third aspect I would like to highlight to you, which is again a sign of the Spirit identifying us as God's own, is just like the Holy Spirit made the spoken word of the Father into a reality when the angel Gabriel gave the message to Mary about God's plan. It was the Holy Spirit who made it into a reality, and Mother Mary conceived Jesus through the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit made it a reality for Mary, a mother. Similarly, the Holy Spirit makes Jesus a reality in our lives. Jesus, His cross, His resurrection, His saving power, a reality in our life. It is the Holy Spirit who makes it possible. Another aspect, the Holy Spirit constantly motivates and empowers us to be the witnesses of Christ. He constantly motivates us, not once in a blue moon or sometimes, every moment of my life, through my words, through my actions, through even my thoughts, even through my prayers, even through my teachings or my entire life or whatever experience, He makes us the witnesses of Christ in different ways. No, there are many ways I can be a witness, but it is the Holy Spirit who empowers me to become His witness. Once I am endowed with the Holy Spirit, filled with the Holy Spirit, I have a deep experience of the Holy Spirit, I am stamped or sealed with the image of God. I am stamped with the image of God, and thereby I am constituted heir of the heavenly inheritance which is prepared for all those who belong to Christ Jesus. In the olden days, you know, those days there were no identity cards or your Aadhaar card or whatever, no? Those days that they used to carry the seal of maybe a royal family or any of your office or your authority. The seal was a sign. So similarly here, the Holy Spirit is a sign, is a stamp that I am an heir of God. Thereby I will receive the inheritance of heaven which God has prepared for me for eternity. Also, the stamping or sealing of the Holy Spirit produces in every man a new nature, whereby man is marked to be the son of the Most High God. Right? I am marked to be the son or daughter of the Most High God. I remember many years ago, one of our priest in the renewal taught us, you know, to always make this a regular prayer. I am the son of God first, a sinner second. Let me repeat it for you. I am the son of God first, a sinner second. So brothers and sisters, this is the work of the Holy Spirit. As He identifies us, you and me, as God's own. Ephesians 6:17 accepts salvation as a helmet and the word of God as the sword which the Spirit gives you. Brothers and sisters, as we have heard and believed in the good news of Jesus, as we have already given our lives to the Lord, I ask each one of you to renew your commitment as we prepare for Pentecost, to renew our commitment as to truly repent, to truly commit our lives to be the witnesses of Christ and allow the Holy Spirit to not only show us the will of God, but to enable us also to do the will of God. I am a son of God first, a sinner second. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I pray that the Holy Spirit, as you prepare through this Pentecost, the Holy Spirit will fill you, your heart and mind, and make you like Christ to inherit the eternal life of God. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Novena to the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, Lord and Giver of life. Fill the hearts of the faithful and kindle in us the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit and we shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, you instruct the hearts of your faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit. Give us the same Spirit. Under His divine inspiration, may we relish and do what is right and just, and always experience His consolation. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen. The ninth day, self-control. O God, give me in my life the fruit of self-control. Please take control of me so that I am controlled by your love alone. Help me always to control my temper, my tongue, my feelings and my impulses. Grant that I may never be swept away in a moment of anger or passion. Help me to control my thoughts so that no bitter or unclean thought stays in my mind. Help me overcome habits of self-abuse, smoking, alcoholism, and all immorality. Help me to control my impulses and passions wisely, not by repressing them, but by channeling them to works of mercy. I make this prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Fiat Prayer. Most Holy Spirit, help us in union with Mary to relieve the joyful, sorrowful and glorious mysteries of Jesus. Grant that we may be inspired by the faith of our baptism, nourished by the Eucharist, renewed in the grace of Pentecost, so as to live in word and deed, always and everywhere as faithful witnesses of Christ and of the love of His divine heart. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.